the true spirit of us and the true meaning of us was to be able to train when you didn't feel like it. When your body didn't want to, when you're tired, when you're hurt, and when you don't want to, he says it takes a special person to train. Anybody can do it when you're feeling good and strong and healthy. But when you're feeling tired and, you know, aches and pains, and you push yourself through, it takes a special person. So I think everyone's feeling that way now. And, you know, it's part of, for me, Aikido, in a lot of dojos in the world I see today, Aikido is no longer Budo. It's become some sort of a martial dance. Or as a friend of mine said, spiritual martial masturbation. But honestly, it's like that because it's just people feeling good about themselves. It's about feeling good, but it's also about developing, becoming better. And if you don't push the envelope, you'll only ever feel good. You'll never become a better person. So to become a better person, you need to push yourself. Everyone sit comfortably here. I just want to talk about the role of uke. So now, you might want to turn the camera off. I'm Sunny's senior, I'm his teacher, yeah? So he does nikkazo, and I'm like this. Go on, tell me how it is. How's your day? It's very easy for me to lock him up. He's never going to learn if I do that. So my job when I'm senior is to let him have my hand and create the shape for him. Look at my body, it's already in the shape. So what he now does is he learns to emulate that shape. He learns to recognize that shape. When he does it to someone junior to him, he tries to find that same shape. And that's the traditional training, that's the kata training. That's why if you go to all koryu, it's the senior person who has the sword and who accepts the technique. Like in Shindo Musu Jodo, the senior person will accept the technique. Right? Because they lead the timing, they're showing the way. So now, it's my job not to maybe give him the Encyclopedia Britannica version of how to do nikkazo, but to just set it up for him. And if a lot of you are trying to help each other, you can help each other more by being a good uke rather than explaining things. Now, his job, when I give him my hand and set it up and relax, is not to abuse it. His job is to respect that. And so you don't snap things off, you do it gradually. Okay, that's the role of a uke, of a senior person. Not to lock your partner up, but to give in. Right? And the junior person remembers that shape, respects it, and then tries to emulate it in someone else. Okay, so now, we're going to do some jiwaza, now that everyone's tired. Good planning on my part. So we're 1 meter apart, yeah? Now, my partner's going to do Shumasu Saichi. Ni, sa, I, one more time. Down. Ichi, ni, sa, chi. Okay? So here. Ichi. Now what he's doing, just brushes my knee. Sa, chi. Now let's come up. We should not close any. It's me beside me. Sa. Okay? That's what I want you to try. So try and get that closeness, but you don't want to do it like this, yeah? So two together. Okay, so when I say come out, we're 1 mat apart, yeah? And we're gonna go move this way. Wow. On the next move, to avoid him, I shouldn't do this. I should have this one has set up the angle. The next move just brushes through. I don't hit him, I don't twist away from him, turn down. Then when I do Shumasu Sani, yeah, so from here, turn. 1, 2, 3, 4. If I do this, I'm going to be too far. Okay? So, everyone, let's just try that, yeah? With your partner.